Hello viewers, today we're going to discuss something many of you may have already experienced. You're driving down the road and everything seems to be just fine. And then, all of a sudden, the engine loses its power and doesn't want to speed up anymore despite you pressing the pedal to the floor. At this point, you'll probably realize that your car went into limp mode. This, however, usually happens at random, which makes diagnosing a problem a bit difficult. So, to help you out with this, we will explore what the limp mode actually is and, more importantly, what to do when it happens to your own car. But before we do that, make sure to subscribe and hit that notification button to get all the latest updates from our channel. First, let's see what is limp mode. Limp mode is a safety function built into your vehicle's drivetrain to protect it from being damaged when something goes wrong. When the engine or transmission control units conclude that some of the critical running parameters are out of line, they will send the car into limp mode. This usually reduces the power and limits the engine RPM, allowing you to reach the workshop without the risk of additional damage. For example, the ECU may detect your turbo boost pressure is 2 bars when it should be 1.3 bar at maximum. This is called overboost and it can damage your pistons and other engine internals quickly. So, in that case, the ECU will engage limp mode to protect the engine. Sure, the check engine itself is here to warn the driver about engine and transmission issues, but many car owners choose to ignore this light and continue driving. So, when something is seriously wrong, the ECU sends the vehicle into limp mode, effectively forcing the owner to address the issue without delay. Next, let's go over the limp mode symptoms. The check engine light is probably the first thing you will notice on your dashboard when the car is in limp mode. This will usually come together with a transmission warning light or similar ones. However, many issues may trigger a check engine light, so when it goes on, it is definitely time to check the trouble codes with a OBD2 scanner. This is the only way to properly diagnose the problem. Next, you will likely have reduced engine power. When your car notices something is seriously wrong with the engine or transmission, it will take steps to protect them from further damage. In turbocharged cars, the ECU will shut down the turbo to cut down the boost. And even in engines without turbochargers, it will limit the power output by adjusting things like fuel injection and timing. Another protective feature your ECU uses when setting the car into limp mode is lowering the RPM limit significantly. Most cars won't rev past 3000 RPM when in limp mode, which is one of the most obvious telltale signs. Lastly, if you have an automatic transmission, your car might limit the gear shiftings on your car when it goes into limp mode. In most cases, the transmission will not shift above third gear, but this depends on the model. And as you may imagine, with the engine being limited to 3000 RPM and the transmission not shifting past third gear, you won't be getting anywhere very fast. So, if you're having all these symptoms at once, there's no doubt that your car is in limp mode. Next, let's see what are the causes. The most common cause of limp mode is boost control problems. This can be a boost leak or, more likely, overboost. As you may imagine, overboost happens in turbocharged cars and it is quite critical to your engine and therefore the engine control unit will limit the engine powers because of this. The most common causes of boost pressure problems are faulty turbochargers, wastegates, boost pressure sensors, boost control valves or boost pipe leaks. Faulty engine sensor is another common cause. The engine has many sensors whose malfunctioning may send your car into limp mode and it may not be easy to find out which one is causing this. Still, there is a simple way around this problem, which we will explain later in this video. Next, if you have an automatic transmission, issues with it or its control module can actually set the car into limp mode. This can often be a faulty sensor, low transmission fluid level, or a bad shift solenoid. Lastly, issues with wiring that connects the engine and transmission to rest of the car are another thing that can cause a limp mode. This may be a broken wire, which can be difficult to locate, or something as simple as a loose connector. Let me give you an example. If the boost pressure sensor wiring is broken, the ECU will not be able to control it properly. So, to avoid any additional problems, such as blowing up the engine with overboost, the ECU will send the car into limp mode. Let's get one thing straight. Fixing limp mode issues is not an easy job and may require an in-depth diagnosis. Otherwise, you may end up wasting your money by replacing wrong parts. Still, there are some simple methods and tricks you can try to fix the problem. None of them are guaranteed to work, but most of them are easy and free, so you have nothing to lose by giving them a try. First, as obvious as it sounds, start by checking all fluid levels in your car. These include engine oil, coolant, power steering, transmission, and brake fluids. Any of them being low may cause overheating or excessive mechanical wear. And while you're at it, make sure these fluids are the right color and without any contaminants. If you haven't replaced them in a while, it's maybe time for a fluid change. Next, clean the MIF sensor. This is the sensor that controls the air-fuel mixture in your car and can often become dirty, especially if you have an open air filter. Dust and dirt on the MIF sensor will cause it to send wrong values to the ECU, which may result in limp mode. Remove it and carefully clean the sensor with an electronic cleaner. Remember that the wire inside the sensor that does the measuring is sensitive, and you should not touch it with your hands. The next step is to check and clean or replace the air filter. The air filter ensures that your engine is getting enough clean air without dust or dirt in it. If you haven't replaced it in a while, it can be so clogged that it will cause problems with the air intake. The air filter is usually easily located, so checking its condition is a simple job. If it's filthy and covered with dust, it's time to replace it. In the end, if you checked everything above without results, there is nothing more to do than make a proper diagnosis and not waste your money. Now, let's cover the limp mode diagnosis in detail. This is the best thing you can do when you have a problem with your car. First, connect an OBD2 scanner and check the trouble codes. When the limp mode is activated, there is always a code stored in engine's or transmission's control module. If you can't find any trouble codes, you may want to try another diagnostic scanner. Next, research the trouble code you found in the memory and continue the troubleshooting with that information. You can find a lot about error codes right here on our website. Just save the error code and search for it here. Another thing to do is checking the boost pressure with your diagnostic tool. Make sure it gives realistic readings when idling or while revving the engine. And if faulty, replace the boost pressure sensor. Use a pressure gauge to test the wastegate and make sure it moves freely. Use your diagnostic tool to test the boost control sensor by testing it while pressuring the wastegate. Replace the sensor or replace the wastegate if faulty. Next, check for intake leaks visually or using a smoke machine. Repair any possible leaks or replace a faulty PCV valve. In the end, check the MIF sensor, O2 sensor, engine coolant temperature sensor, throttle position sensor, and air temperature sensor. If any of them are faulty, replace them. Still, if you can't find any faulty parts and solve the issue using the methods above, you may want to consult a professional mechanic. That's all about limp mode for today. If this video helped you, give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. But if it didn't, there might be something else causing a problem. To continue troubleshooting, go to our website or visit our community forum and leave us a question there. The link is in the description.